Thank you very much for receiving me, and thank you very much for this question. You have actually 77 cases pending before the European Court of Human Rights concerning Montenegro. Among the judgments already rendered, you have cases concerning a fair trial, access to court, length of proceedings, execution of problematic execution of judgment by the state. You have also cases concerning up to 3 million
ill treatment. You have cases concerning private life. And finally, you have cases concerning the right to property.
But those are more or less isolated cases. I cannot speak of the structural problem of human rights protection here in Montenegro. So, by and globally speaking, the protection level of protection of human rights in Montenegro is satisfactory. And we have had an excellent meeting today with the Supreme Court and its president. And we have seen the efforts made by the Supreme Court in order to always ameliorate the taking into account of the case of the European Court and ameliorating the protection of human rights in Montenegro.
And the protection of human rights in
fundamental human rights and freedoms to everyone in their territory. And in this regard, the European Court's function is supervisory. Do you believe that Montenegro has established adequate national mechanism for practical and effective protection of implementation of this convention?
Establishing effective national remedies is extremely important because you are right. The European Court of Human Rights is intervening on the basis of subsidiarity. Subsidiarity means two things. It means first that the national authorities have the primary responsibility in protecting human rights through effective remedies especially, and secondly that the European Convention on Human Rights is intervening only if and to the extent that those remedies do not function. So it is extremely important for the national states to go and establish effective remedies. We have found some of those to be effective, but of course amelioration is always possible.
The Supreme Court and Montenegro's representative before the European Human Rights Court have prepared two analyses about execution of the European Court's judgments. Today, the results of that analysis will be presented to public. How important is that activity for a good understanding and implementation of European Court's practices?
I have seen the analysis and I read it in English. I know that the original is your language and I find that this is extremely well drafted document. It's extremely important in order to understand better the case law of European Court of Human Rights and to take into account this case law into the national legal order. So this is a tool of extreme importance as far as the execution process is concerned. And of course the execution of our judgments, the execution of judgments of the European Court of Human Rights is instrumental in guaranteeing the credibility of the whole system. So I think that those documents are contributing greatly to the better understanding and execution process in your country.
The execution system
are prone to developmental changes. And in this regard, the convention is seen as a living instrument. In your opinion, which is the most important and significant area for universal protection of human rights in Europe, to which Montenegro has provided its contribution?
Living instrument doctrine is a condition in order to maintain this document of 70-year-old document.
Taj 70-godišnji dokument i održao.
This is the 70th anniversary of the European Convention. Ovo je 70. godišnjica ove godine, dakle, Evropske konvencije o ljudskim pravima i slobodama.
Mi moramo da zadržimo taj aspekt, da je to živi dokument i da uzimamo u obzir sadašnje uslove života. A da bismo to uradili, moramo da razvijemo tu doktrinu živog dokumenta i dinamičkog tumačenja tog dokumenta, da bismo zadržali korak sa sadašnjim uslovima života. Mi imamo različite predmete sada koji bi bili nezamislivi potpuno za priređivače konvencije prije 70 godina, zato što imamo nove tehnologije, bioetička pitanja i tako dalje, različite nove aspekte. Uvijek idemo naprijed u tumačenju konvencije zbog toga, ali ono što vidim danas kao najznačajniji najznačajnije pitanje jeste vladavina prava i nezavisnost pravosuđa. Jako je važno imati nezavisno pravosuđe da bi pravosudni sistem i pravosuđe mogao da služi kao kontrola ostale dvije grane vlasti. To je tema o kojoj ću danas govoriti na Crnogorskoj akademiji nauka i umjetnosti. Za mene to je ključna tema u današnjem svijetu.
Da, mislim da sudske vlasti, sudske organe treba da budu svjesne da se Evropska konvencija proteže kroz sve grane prava i da je to instrument za svakodnevni rad pravosuđa i da zemlje treba da se oslanjaju na ovu konvenciju, na sudsku pravo, supraticu Evropskog suda za ljudska prava u promovisanju ljudskih prava i sloboda i zaštiti u svojoj zemlji. Hvala.